Live in 3, 2, 1.
Come on stream now?
Yep, welcome Jake. Back to Zerul.
Hi.
So yeah, just in case you guys missed it before the beginning of the last run, we had a little change of plans. Go and check the Hararo, it's being posted in chat. Got a little new schedule going, but right now we're going to play some Pokemon TCG with the Zerul Kirby.
Yep.
Cool, so yeah, I'm ready when you are.
Okay.
I'll give you a 3, 2, 1.
Okay, I just want to say something first. I don't have a lot of practice with this probably won't be too great, but I'm going to do my best.
Okay, alrighty.
So I am ready.
Okay.
So
3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, so this is Pokemon TCG. At the start, we make a deck edit to get a ton of energy. I don't know, it's programmed in a really weird way. So a lot of this, if you don't know how the TCG works, it's kind of very similar to the main way the Pokemon games play, where you go turn by turn, making moves, and you try to knock out the other Pokemon, and when you knock out six, or not six, it depends on, in this game particularly, it's usually 4 or 6, and when you do that, you win the game, or if you knock out all the Pokemon. Sorry if this is very rushed commentary, but I'm trying to focus on the run. I won't be able to explain a lot of the battle mechanics because this I need to focus a lot on this. So I'm editing the deck. We take up the Charmander and Friends deck because the Fires and Diglett are really, really good. The saving because it's easy to lose each match potentially. So, oh, that's not a good start. Oh, okay. So each Pokemon has attacks and you need energy in order to use attacks. So, like, Growlithe has an attack that's 2 energy for 20 damage. So I have to, and it's 1 fire and 1 color, so I can attach a fire and then anything else. So as here, I attach them both, now I can use the attack, and because Venonat's weak to fire, it does double damage. This Porygon's a pretty useless card, it's not really matter. This is... I didn't mean to attach to that, whatever. The first fight can go pretty hard. Oh god, use conversion too. That is not good. That is really bad. He changed his own resistance to fire, so I can't attack him right now. Why is there a Raticate in my deck? I forgot to take that out. God damn it. I can't attack him until I can evolve to Charmeleon and I use Flamethrower. It's the only way I can damage him right now. He's not putting- they're not putting anything on the bench, though. Okay, good. There we go. There we go. There's, Heather. She's one of the more tricky fights in the game. She has a lot of weird Pokemon. Next is... what is it? Brittany? No, not Brittany. I don't remember. But she has basically just a lot of grass Pokemon. Ooh, we got a Scyther from the first- 2 Scythers! That's the best first pack we could have gotten. She has a lot of grass Pokemon. I removed the Rattata again instead of Raticate and Meowth. I'm just gonna change that right now. Thank you, PokéNerd. That's what I'm supposed to do. So she has a lot of grass Pokemon. They die to all the fires in your deck, but she also has a Lickitung, which is particularly annoying because it's not weak to fire, it has a ton of HP, and it can paralyze you every turn. So it's really, really annoying. Hopefully she doesn't get the Lickitung. Though if she does, we can use Diglett or Machop because it's weak to fighting. Okay, there we go. Fire Punch. And our other Pokemon's an Oddish, so... that... yep, okay, good. And as long as she doesn't paralyze us, we've won this. Okay, good, we won. There we go, Kristen. That's Kristen, that was her name. So up next is Brittany. Brittany is honestly one of the harder fights in the game. Like, her deck is really dumb, because it has, like, 5 different types of Pokemon. So there's no, like, consistency at all. Okay, Ponyta's not a bad start. Ponyta has attack that's 2 for 30, which is really good. Oh god, that Magmar, though. Okay, good, she didn't get any energy for it, that's good. Bill is just free 2 cards. It's one of the best cards in the game, because you just play and you get 2 cards. Absolutely amazing, you want as many of those as possible. This Magmar can be annoying. It's a good thing she didn't get any energy for it. Because it has an attack that basically, if it uses Smokescreen on me, every time I try to attack... oh, it's gonna use it, okay. Basically, I have to flip a coin before I actually attack. Fuck, I touched the wrong one. So that... Okay, I got heads. If it was tails, my attack would have failed. It's a good thing I got heads. Jinx is all... Oh my god, she got through two of her highest HP Pokemon in her deck. But she has no energy for them, which is great for me. Oh yeah, there's a lot of flashing. Sorry about that, people. I'm just putting in a lot of bench Pokemon. It's faster not to do that. It's kind of just bad. It's a bad habit on my part that I try to, like, attach as many. Just have as much backup as possible. Sometimes you do need as much backup as possible for some of the harder fights in the game. Not as big of a deal right now. Yeah, Scyther, later in the run, it just destroys people. Damn, I don't have any switches or anything. Oh, I have a Charmeleon. That's actually nice. By the way, just in case you're wondering in the chat, Sammy C and Stupid PokéNerd are also runners of the game, so they might also be able to help me comment on some things. Thank you, guys. Okay, cool. Next, it's just a Ghastly. Ghastly's easy peasy. One of the worst cards ever printed, by the way. There we go, that's Brittany. Up next, we're gonna go the Electric Club, and I think Nick, I forget which one is which, but, one of the electric trainers, he's pretty easy. He had basically all of his, the only thing is he has a lot of 50 HP basic Pokemon, really, and he rarely ever evolves them. So it's not too bad. If he evolves, it could be a problem, but that really rarely happens. It's good to start with Rattata because there's no retreat cost. So I can just swap, and ooh, I got a Ductrio in my starting hand, that's great. So I can basically just swap into any other Pokemon. Same thing to a Diglett. Diglett also has no retreat cost. But yeah, this is a great starting hand because Ductrio, by the way, is probably the best Pokemon in this entire run. So it's, yeah, because it can just, it has a lot of power, a good amount of HP. Really good. Its other attack does like 70 damage, which like one-shots everything. Its other attack is like 40. Oh, I could have used a plus power last turn. I didn't know I had that in my hand. Plus power adds 10 damage to your attack, so I could have just added an extra bit of damage. I could use my 70 HP attack right now, but whenever you do it, it does 10 damage to all the Pokemon on the bench. So I want to use that as little as possible. Because basically there's an animation of it damaging the Pokemon on your bench. So there we go, that's whichever trainer this is. I don't remember all the names. Nicholas, yeah, Nicholas. Up next is another electric trainer. He's also pretty easy. He has a lot of Pokemon which just die by Diglett's or Machop's. Ooh, Raichu's pretty good. But if he gets a Zapdos, we're kind of fucked. So hopefully we don't get a Zapdos. Okay, we got a Professor Oak, that's something. Start Zapdos, I honestly might as well just reset. So that's one of the cool things. Saving in this game is really fast. So whenever something goes bad, it's really easy to just reset. It's really fast. And also, it's really fast to save just right before each battle because it's just so ridiculous. Yeah, Ductrio just completely wrecks everything in this game. Also, I'm going to get Ductrio next turn, so we're pretty much won if he doesn't get another basic Pokemon. Okay. We might not kill it. Oh, that's a Machoke, not a Ductrio. I'm wrong. I saw it was a fighting evolution. It was Machoke. There we go. Now we won. Yeah. You can reset in the middle of battle and just, like, do your turnover if you mess something up. It's kind of complicated to explain when you can or not. But, yeah. So now we're going to edit our deck. We're going to get rid of Growlithe and Arcanine. Ooh, two extra Magmars. That's great. Get rid of the Machop and the Machoke. Add more Diglett's. Diglett is pretty fucking amazing. The Rattatas. Add any trainers that are good. An extra Bill. An extra Switch. Energy removal's great. Gust of Wind is really good. Add a full heal. There we go. So this is Jennifer. She has, like, only Pikachu Pokemon. So, like, she has Pikachu, Flying Pikachu, Surfing Pikachu. And Diglett kills a lot of it. The only problem is her Flying Pikachu resists fighting. So, if we're lucky, she doesn't get... She just got a Flying Pikachu. God damn it. That being said, we're just gonna have to end up switching out to our Magmar to kill it. I don't have a Ponyta, but I have a Magmar. Yeah, no, I kept a Ponyta in the deck, purposefully poking it. I can't attack it at all because it's resistant. I'm just gonna wait until I can use Flamethrower. There we go. And that's Flamethrower to kill the Pikachu that's dead. Up next is, I think, Isaac, he's the Electric Club Leader. Oh, Club Leaders are like gym leaders. I don't remember. Some Club Masters? Whatever. He's pretty ridiculously easy. Everything dies to Diglett, and nothing can damage Diglett in his deck except his Tauros and Kangaskhan, though he never attacks with Kangaskhan ever for, like, any reason. And, the Tauros can be a threat, but it's easy enough to deal with when you know it's there. By the way, fun fact, this Electabuzz has two attacks, Thundershock and Thunder Punch. Isaac will never use Thundershock, or never use Thunder Punch. He'll never use the second attack ever, which is interesting. The AI is kind of programmed differently for different fights. Bill into Bill, great. Okay, we're good. I'm paralyzed, you just can't attack for a turn. Which, basically, you can get easily fucked by this game if you just get paralyzed, like, 5 turns in a row. It happens. As I always say, you're not speedrunning TCG unless you get, paralyzed 5 times in a row, or get smokescreened 5 times in a row, or something along that line. By the way, yeah, the rest of this fight is easy peasy. Unless he gets a Tauros, but I think I have a Gust in my hand anyway, so if he does get a Tauros, it's fine. By the way, he just placed down an Electrode, which has Sonic Boom, which is supposed to bypass weakness and resistance, but he never uses it, even though it would kill my Diglett. He just doesn't use the attack. I'm not complaining about that, but you know, it's a thing. Also, I need to look at his bench. I was noticing, just to make sure if he has a Tauros or not. He doesn't, okay. Yeah, the rest of this fight's basically just use Mudslap every turn and win. I used wrong attack. This is an example you can just reset. Continue duel, use the other move. There we go, I win. That's the thing you can do in this game. It's very cheaty. It's very cheaty. Like, kind of ridiculous, but, you know, it works, and it makes the game faster. And that's Isaac. We're going to... Next is Nikki, who's the Grass Club Leader. We had to fight all the Grass Trainers earlier in order to, We had to fight all the Grass Trainers earlier in order to, In order to make her appear at a certain house. Like, we have to talk to her... Oh, oops, I forgot I'm not out of the club yet. You have to talk to her at Ishihara's house, and then she goes to the club, and then you can battle her there. Yet she doesn't appear there until you battle all the grass trainers. A lot of this game is different depending on different cards you get in packs and stuff like that. So, like, I have 3 Magmars, which is great, but other times I could get, like, nothing special at all, and it would just be terrible. So Nikki, she's a joke, by the way. Again, second club leader, she's pretty much a joke. Everything dies to a 30. She has basically just a ton of grass Pokemon. They're weak to fire, and they all have less than 60 HP. So you can easily do a 30 HP Fire Punch or Ember or Flame Tail, which are Charmander, Magmar, and Ponyta's attacks, and just kill everything. Occasionally, she'll evolve Execute or Bulbasaur or Oddish. But very rarely. Speak of the devil. It doesn't matter, because we can just, fuck, we don't have any, oh, that's not good. Whatever. We can just kill it. It's not going to attack us. It's, again, kind of a joke. I could have used Flamethrower last turn, but I wanted to play it safe because if I hadn't drawn a Fire Energy the next turn, I wouldn't have been able to attack. Because when you use Flamethrower, you have to discard one of your Fire Energies attached. By the way, the only pack we care about is Coliseum. They have all the useful cards for the run. This is Ronald. He's your rival. He's definitely not blue at all. The entire point of this fight is that we want to actually lose as fast as possible. Because there's no penalty for losing. Just if you win, you get a card. And it's not a card we want. And it's a lot. It's a lot slower to lose. Or that's all slower to win the fight, so we just lose. We just have him knock out our Pokemon and continue on our way. There we go, that's him. Now we're gonna fight Chris. Honestly, if I were to be honest, this is the hardest... Or Michael, not Chris, Michael. This is the hardest fight in the entire game. It's kind of ridiculous, because he has a ton of super high HP... Pokemon that do a lot of damage, and it's fucking dumb. I should have used Dig, but whatever, I'm not gonna reset. I forgot, I wanted to use energy removal. I wanted to do that, just so I couldn't use Stretch Kick, because I need to keep all the HP I have. It's a really powerful deck, and it can easily just kill the run easily. Oh god, he has another one? Fuck. Hold up, I think Charmander is more valuable right now. I'm gonna put down a second Charmander. There we go, I'm doing that, because he's probably gonna put attack the Charmander that he already stretch kicked. I should have done that earlier, I made a mistake with that. Yeah, so I want to get the other one to have energy. Because that one's going to die, probably, so... There we go. I just have to very much manipulate this fight to make it go as well as possible. Oh, god damn it, he can Fire Punch. That is really bad. Okay, I know what I can do. I know what to do. There we go, I'm going to do this. He's going to kill this one next turn, and then I'm going to finish it off with the other Charmander. I see, you can do a lot of damage. There we go. Okay, will he... Okay, cool, we beat him. Good, good. Yeah, that fight he has can do a lot of damage stuff. He has another Pokemon you didn't see. Like, he has Electabuzzes, which can do a ton of damage. He has Hitmonchans, one of the best Pokemon in the game. So yeah, we're lucky. That fight went really well. Gyarados. Come on, give me Dugtrio, please. Item Finder, that's actually really good. Item Finder is one of the best cards we can get. So now we go to the Fire Club? Actually, no, hold up. No, I fight Amanda next. That's right. So Amanda, this is a water trainer, and yes, we're using a fire deck for this. Her deck is really dumb. What? Oh god, she has four Pokemon to start with? Fuck. Okay, I'm gonna computer search... Fuck, I think I need... I'm just gonna reset this fight. This fight's that's not good. It's a really bad start. I probably could have gotten, like, a Magmar or something, but... Yeah. Okay, this is better. Started Scyther. I got... By the way, I often press select whenever you're, Oh god, fuck. Oh god, I don't think there's anything I can do about that. I didn't know she had double colors in her hand. Basically, she could go straight to Slash. It lets her get two energy at one time. She does that, so... Hopefully she doesn't get another basic. If she doesn't get another basic, we win. Damn, she got a Poliwag. That's actually loses the fight, basically. I can't do anything. Because if I kill the Poliwag, it would just send out the Scyther and kill me anyway. This happens along the run. You just lose a fight, but you just gotta restart immediately. Recognize your losses. I thought her deck was hard. This is not an easy fight at all. It's very... Because, like, her Pokemon are really annoying. Scyther is ridiculously annoying. Which, like, your fires are the best way to take out the Scyther. That's why we use it to begin with. But, I don't know what's the best option right now. I'm gonna do this. Let the Charmander die, basically. And he's gonna retreat, probably. No, he's not gonna retreat it. Okay, that's good. The Scyther is dead. That's ideal. I want to send the Ponyta. I accidentally clicked that. I'm just letting it happen so that... like, this fight can be really hard, so I'm just resetting. It's gonna lose time, but, you know, this happens on the game. Amanda's she is a hard fight. It can just... Sometimes it goes really well, but other times it goes really badly, because it's just... It's one of the most inconsistent decks to battle against. Fuck, I didn't want to touch in fighting. Whatever. What do I want to do that. Okay, I got it. There we go. That worked. I want to keep my Magmar alive as much as I can. I'm really low on energy stuff. Oh, she has another Scyther on the bench. Yeah, the Clefairy Dolls and Fossils just have like 10 HP or so. So yeah. Oh god, she switched to the Poliwag. That's not good. I'm gonna have to get rid of my Dugtrio because I need to get more cards. This is really tricky right now. Oh, she won! Fuck, she took all my... She took all the prizes! Fuck, I forgot that was a thing. I always forget that, because usually you lose when you run out of Pokemon, but this is like a smaller prize battle, so because she knocked out 3 Pokemon, she won that fight. This is why TCG is a weird speed game, because it's just so completely random and bullshit. Just looking at my cards, looking through my options. Okay. Okay, I want a oak to get more fires. Here we go. And he's not gonna- they're not gonna attach a final energy- actually, no, they might. They might attach another energy. Okay, no, they didn't. Good. Cool. I actually have a ton of those on the bench. Oh, he evolved into an Omnite, okay. Sure. The mysterious fossils can evolve into Omnites or Kabutos. I rarely see that ever happen in the game. Okay, she has a Dugtrio on the bench, or a Jigglypuff. It's fine, my Diglett will kill it. Okay, she's probably gonna send the Jigglypuff, and then... I'm gonna mud slap it and I'll win. Yeah, that's it. I'm gonna take the final prize card and win. I didn't mean to hit end turn. The good thing we have the reset option. This is not cheating. It's a intended feature. There we go. Amanda is getting a pretty tricky fight. Okay, so now we're gonna be doing something kind of odd. I'm going to get rid of all the basics in my deck. And I'm going to add only 2 Scythers. I'm lucky to have 2. That's actually great. Also, let me look at my trainers. Another Bill. That's good. Another thing. Fossils are great. Item Finder. I want that. Okay. Hold up, how many oaks? I have one oak. I'm not a gambler. And now I need to add a lot of energy and stuff. 3 double colas, that's nice. Yeah, I got 2 thysers from Heather. So now we're just gonna fight 4 trainers, and we're only- actually no, 3 trainers? 3 trainers. And Scyther just kind of destroys them. This is the hardest of the fights, like, it's possible for this one to go wrong. This is the only one that I won't automatically lose. I forgot to take out- forgot to take out those, oops. Forgot to take out the fires in the deck. As you see, I'm not run this game a lot in a while. So yeah, basically, we're gonna be using that Scyther that just basically completely fucked us before. It has, basically, the 3 trainers we're about to fight, basically just have, fighting Pokemon. Oh, fuck, that's not good. Okay, no, we should be fine. Yeah, it just have fighting Pokemon, so barely anything can even damage us at all. So we just basically plow through them. So one thing that we do is, instead of- so that Slash does 30 damage. But we want to use Sword Stance first, because that doubles it the next turn. Now why does that matter at all? It matters because, Slash has a slower animation than Sword Stance. So it saves a few frames if we do that. It also manipulates their AI, because if they have, like, 20 HP left after a single Slash, they might use a potion the next turn. So, also by killing them in one shot, by Sword Stance slashing, it makes them not potion. It's a bit of AI manipulation. Okay, cool. And this fight's the easiest of them all. The literal only thing in this fight is that he has this Rhyhorn, which prevents you from using an attack. Oh my god, 3 bills. Okay. So basically, this whenever he gets heads on Leer, you can't attack next turn. Basically, so it's basically, what is all my bills? It's basically a paralysis, unless you have a Pokemon on your bench to switch to. So you want to get- the Rhyhorns are really annoying. You don't Sword Stance those when possible, because you don't want to get Leered, you just do that. So, because basically, if you get Leered, the Sword Stance doesn't matter, because it only affects the next one. Okay, good. We're getting good flips. Oh, he energy removaled me. Okay, that's interesting. I didn't realize he was going to energy removal me, but I had another double colorless. Good. Energy removal just, as it says, just removes one. Everything. Yeah, the rest of the fight's going to be easy. Just everything dies. I don't know if you can hear me mashing. This entire game, for the entire run, it's just mash heaven. There we go, that's him. Like, I'm mashing, because one thing that's really interesting about this fight, or about this game, is that the text speed is instant. Like, it just goes straight from one message to the next message. Like, there's no scrolling text. At least this is an option. You can set in the options to go that way. And it's completely ridiculously makes this game fast. Next is Jessica. She's the last fighting trainers. She's kind of a joke. She can do something, potentially, depending on what she draws, but it's pretty easy. Are you mashing loud? Okay. Sorry about that, I guess. I just wanted to use all the- I didn't really need to, because I'm probably going to win turn 2. Yeah, I'm just going to win turn 2, cool. I didn't need to play all those bills, that wasted time. There we go, that's Jessica. Okay, so now we're gonna switch back to fightings. Fighting is- just fightings. We're not gonna put the fire back in. That's the end of the fires for the run. Yeah, and rats. Fires and rats. So that, the rats aren't useful for the next fight, but it's good for the fight after that. And we don't want to- we want to deck it as not often as possible. So we're gonna add all our Diglets and Nectria. Oh, cool, I did get an extra Diglet. Oh, wait, hold up, I forgot to do something. I'll do that after this. Hold on, I'm just gonna... in a quick editing so I can... After this fight, I'm supposed to go to this PC, and I can take out 3 pieces of mail. I can get 3 Colosseum packs. While I get... Item Finder, that's a good pull. Item Finders are great. Hitmonchan, I don't need that. It's a good card, but it's not good for the run. Gyarados. Okay, at least I got an Item Finder. Basically, yeah, we do that so we can get 3 Colosseum packs to potentially get more cards. I should have probably waited until after the fight, just because I was already up here. But whatever. I just wanted to get that away so I didn't forget about it later. Take out the Scythers, put in the Diglets and the Dugtrios, and I'm gonna put in 2 Rattatas. Let me look at my trainers. Oh, we got an extra Oak, that's nice. Good. That. Energy searches are good. I'm gonna take out the Gambler. Item Finder. There we go. There we go. So now we're gonna fight Ken. He's the fire leader. We don't even have to battle any of his trainers. We can just fight him immediately. I think the condition to battling him is that you have like 100 cards or something. It's not hard to do at all. Hold up, I didn't start with a... I'm just gonna restart because I didn't start with a Diglett. Diglett just helped so much in this fight. Okay, I have a computer search, that's fine. Yeah, the part... one... oh, god, he start... am I... okay, good, he didn't one-turn me, thank god. He almost killed me in one turn. Oh, I got a Diglett, cool. That also means I'll be able to get a Dugtrio once I get enough energy. That will be actually really nice. This Tauros is a problem. One of the biggest problems with this fight is Chansey. You'll see that when that comes up. If he doesn't get a Chansey, I will be surprised. I got a fucking Dugtrio too, and so it means I still have a computer search in my hand. Like, I thought I would need to use it for the Diglett. I thought I needed to use it for the Dugtrio. I still got it. I'm gonna use it. I'm not gonna get a plus power. I'm just gonna. I would get a plus power, but I want to save the computer search in case I need an extra energy. There we go. I got it. Whatever. Okay. Cool. Anyway, this fight's won basically now. Dugtrio will kill literally everything. It's a 78 damage attack. Yep, it's pretty ridiculous. Does he not have a Chansey? He didn't get a Chansey. Wow, Ken. We'll probably see that in the next fight, though. Oh, he's still... never mind, there's a Chansey. There we go. Chansey has an attack that's Crunch, called Scrunch. Flip a coin. If heads, you cannot be attacked the next turn. So again, it's basically paralysis. If it ever gets heads, you just can't attack it. It's really weird. It should be one of the hardest fights in the game. Also, hey, now I can... now it's a good idea to computer search that plus power. He is a defender, so it makes him take 20 less damage. I'm gonna do 10 more damage, just enough to kill him. And there's Chansey. Okay, cool, he didn't get to use the attack, thank god. It has 120 HP! 120 HP! And an attack that makes it invincible for a turn, so it's pretty fucking dumb. Also, I had 2 gusts in my hand, so it wouldn't have mattered anyway. But whatever. It'd probably be a problem next fight, though. And there's 3 fights in the game where Chanseys are important. This fight, the next fight, and Jack. So up next is Murray, one of the hardest fights to do casually, because he has a kind of broken combo in Alakazam plus Mr. Mime. If he gets an Alakazam, we will quit the fight right there. Like, if he gets an Alakazam, we will just quit. I have an Oak in my hand, so that's fine. Fucking, I dropped my Dugtrio, are you serious? I need to Oak just to get a Diglett. I didn't get a Diglett, I'm resetting. Diglett is very necessary for this fight because he has a ton of colorless Pokemon. By the way, you keep resetting. Are you serious here? We need Rattata in the deck though for Mr. Mime because as Mr. Mime, it does. Are you fucking with me? I have 4 Diglets and 2 Rattatas. I have an oak. I mean, I have a computer search. We're fine. Computer search, by the way, I didn't explain earlier. You can take any card you want out of your deck. So yeah, this Chansey is... we're gonna get into this. Oh my god, the energy removal. Fuck you. Scrunch Boys. Basically, if it gets heads, it can't attack it, so let's hope that doesn't happen. Though, I do have a Gust, so I can move it out of the way if that happens, but... Also, I can potentially, I can potentially manipulate the coin flip. Oh, that's not a good thing for him to get. That is definitely not a good thing for him to get. Fuck? Okay, hold up. I might want to switch out to the Rattata for this. Okay, yeah, I'm switching out to Rattata. I need to keep my Diggle alive. Rattata resists Psychic, so yay. No, it doesn't have Soft Boil. Funny enough, its other attack is Double Edge, which does 80 damage to itself. That's its other attack. It doesn't have any mimes, we're good. I have a Duck Trio in hand, which is great. I need to hope that I don't get that he doesn't drop a Mr. Mime. Because Mr. Mime, you can only do basically, its ability, it prevents you from doing more than 10 damage to it. Oh, sweet! Okay, cool, he's dead. Good. That could have gone a lot worse, honestly. Again, if he gets Alakazam, the fight's just lose. You just reset. Because if he gets Alakazam, he can move any damage counter on his own Pokemon around anywhere he wants. So basically, you do, like, whatever amount of damage to him, he just switches it to something else, and therefore, basically, he's infinite health. You don't want to do that. Especially if he also gets Mr. Mime, because that can't take more than 20 damage. So, yeah. I forgot to save the game beforehand. Whatever. Hopefully this goes well enough. Okay. This is fine. Oh god, he started... So like I said, I want to lose... This is another Ronald fight. I want to lose as quickly as possible. The problem is that he has fucking Kangaskhan, which will not attack you. His other Pokemon's Mewtwo. Are you kidding me? Trying to get a... Trying to get a plus power. Damn it. I was hoping to get a plus power so I could one-shot the Kangaskhan right there. Or two-shot, I guess, rather. Okay, he actually does have psychic energy. And he does have... Okay, never mind. He'll be able to kill me with that. But yeah, basically, we want to lose as fast as possible. The problem is that he will never attack. Are you fucking with me? I have an item. Hold up. I don't have a Gust in there. How many cards are left in my deck? 16. There we go, Gust. Send out that fucking Himanshan. Kill me, please. Please kill me. This is literally the worst Ronald 2 I've ever had. That was fucking ridiculous. I actually almost decked myself out. I had 8 cards left. Where's next? Oh yeah, I have to... So I'm gonna go talk to this guy in here. And get a Mewtwo! Yay! That's really helpful for 2 fights in the game. He just gives us a free Mewtwo for beating Murray. Now we're gonna go to the Water Club. That's not the Water Club. Now we're gonna go to the Water Club. We're gonna switch to an electric deck. Pikachu, Raichu, and Electabuzz, which are really good. We want this Pikachu and this Raichu. And you have Electabuzzes? Damn it, no Electabuzzes. Oh well, we're still fine without them. Pikachu is a pretty good powerhouse against these Pokemon. By the way, again, thanks for PokéNerd and Sammy for talking about stuff in the chat. Because this game does take a lot of concentration. So yeah, we basically kill a lot of these Pokemon here with Pikachu. Come on, don't get heads, please. Damn it. This is the one Pokemon that does... This is, by the way, I'm gonna put out there, this is the easiest fight in the entire game. It's basically impossible to lose. It's a two-prize game, you get Pikachu, you just kill everything. It's usually a three-turn fight. Unless she gets Slowpoke first. That's what prevents it from being a three-turn fight. There we go, I just won. I'm gonna use the potion just in case I... If I were to get Tails with this attack and damage myself, we would have been a tie, which counts as a loss. So, yeah, easiest fight in the game. Usually a three-turn fight was four turns because she got Slowpoke. The Slowpoke's not weak to electric like everything else. It's probably gonna be two Gyaradoses. No, okay. Neither of those cards are useful, though. As you know, so I do save before every fight just in case it's bad. It's worth doing that, honestly. It's not just, like, safety. It is safety strats, I guess, but I mean, like, it's worth it, even playing casually. Do I have a plus power? Damn it. I wish I had a plus power right now. Because I could one-shot this shelter. Oh yeah, I didn't explain. Pikachu's two attacks. One energy for 10 damage, two energy for 30. If you did Tails on the 30, you do 10 to yourself. I didn't need to use that attack, but whatever. Time moves into sudden death? Okay, that's right. Yeah, basically everything here, we're just thunder jolting to death. Because it just completely destroys them all. And, yeah. If she gets- okay, no Lapras's, that's actually really good. Oh god, Cloyster though. Ah, he didn't attach another energy. We're fine. So there we go, that's Joshua. I accidentally stuck that card multiple times. By the way, Clefairy's a rare card for some reason. It's in the rare. We say no just so we can save. We can battle her immediately, but we want to save. This Amy. Amy's pretty easy. I forget. I think she also has Lapras, so that's a problem. Other than the Lapras, everything else is pretty easy to kill. Raichu is really good again in this fight. Oh, good, I got a Raichu. That's actually great. Ooh, and I have... Ooh, that's actually really good because I have double colors for my deck. I can just get it out next turn and use my attack. Also, I want to make sure she has... If she has any Lapras or anything. No Lapras, cool. Computer search. Well, first let me make Bill. I don't know why I didn't use that last turn. Another Bill! There we go. There we go. Let me get double colors. So we can use agility. Does less damage than Thunder Jolt. It only does 20, but all of her Pokemon have 40 HP, and it's weak, so we'd knock out everything anyway. Oh, unless that happens. Oh god, that's not good. Okay, good. You got Tails on Withdraw. Withdraw prevents him from taking damage. That's why I couldn't damage him next turn. Also, I don't want to use that attack. I want to use this attack. Does more damage. Boom, 120 damage. My health is pretty low. That could be- Oh, god, Blastoise. Okay, good. I didn't get Tails. If I get with the other, if I get Tails, I do 30 damage to myself, which obviously is not a thing we want. There we go, that's something I want, Let's see if I get heads. Damn it, okay. That's because I didn't get heads, I'm going to, I'm gonna energy removal this horsey, treat to fossil, use fossil, discard the fossil, send this back out, agility again. Basically, by retreating, it removes the smokescreen effect. The smokescreen, again, it makes me flip a coin, and if tails, then I can't do it anything. Damn it. Damn it, nothing I can do to undo that coin flip. Okay, there we go. Now we win the fight. To flip a coin of heads, we can attack, which that's how this motion works. But again, basically paralysis in terms of 50-50 chance you don't do anything. Yeah, science is next. We're going to be first trainer, Joseph. His deck is basically flying themed, so the electric Pokemon keep working. I'd say he's the second easiest fight in the game. So yeah, pretty easy. I'm gonna save anyway, just because this is a marathon, so we don't want to lose too much time. Pikachu good. Damn, I only have one plus power in my deck. Sorry, cough. Oh, come on. Oh god, that's... Oh, never mind, I still won. Do I have a potion in my hand? Yeah, I do. Okay, we're good. And there we go, two turns. 3-1. Okay, next fight is Rick. We're gonna be switching to Mewtwo. We're gonna only use Mewtwo. Because it's really powerful and it kills basically everything in his deck. The only deck it doesn't kill is Porygon, and Porygon doesn't do any damage anyway. It's easy. It's gonna be like Scyther, where we just have it and nothing else. There's not really much to say about these fights. I'm gonna get rid of these colors now. Yeah, I have more fighting energy than I have psychic, so, yeah. Oh god, I'm gonna put him fossil on the bench. Both fossils on the bench. Okay, we're good. Okay, we basically have to wait until we can attach enough energy, but whatever. Please don't touch. Okay, good. Oh, Porygon. Like I said before, Porygon will take 10 damage. Basically, it is basically invincible because it's resistance 20, and our attack does 40 damage. No, resistance 30. Resistance is minus 30. So it can only do 10, but it can't attack us, so yeah. Also, my Mewtwo is now weak to water. That will not matter at all, but he can sometimes make your weakness grass, which can make the rest of this fight kind of annoying. But yeah, everything else in the deck will just completely die to this 40 damage Psyburn. Though he can be really annoying if he paralyzes, like he has a Grimer that can paralyze you, 50-50. Coughing and wheezing can do kind of annoying things sometimes. Yeah, Porygon can do that. Porygon can change weaknesses. That's conversion. I'm pretty sure it can do that in the games too, can't it? I'm not sure how conversion works in the games. Anyway, now we're gonna fight the last club leader. We're gonna fight Mitch. Same deal, except this fight's actually hard because he actually has Pokemon that will damage you a lot. Like he has Machops, Hitmonchan, Hitmonlees. So that it can it is this fight does have the potential to just lose. Oh, he goes first. That's definitely not a thing I want to happen. Oh, energy removal. That's the thing I do want to happen. Also, this might be bad. I only have one psychic energy right now. I need two to use my attack. Two and a color, so it could be three psychic or something like that. Okay, I need to get lucky and hope I get a psychic next turn. Fuck. We're fucked. I might lose right now. Yeah, I lose. Just need to restart. Didn't have enough psychic energy to use my attack. we go. Okay, we have at least we have one psychic to start with. That's good. Mankey's a whatever start because it has no, can't even attack. There we go, psychic. And next turn, we're basically probably gonna win. We have to at least be careful. Oh, he has a Hitmonlee on the bench. That's scary. Okay, I have a potion in my hand. Should be good. But this might be scary if he high jump kicks me. He has enough energy to do it. That's really scary. What I really wanted is a gust. Yeah, oh, okay, we're looking. This doesn't look bad right now. If he gets him a chop, it's bad. If he gets him a chop, it's... Oh, God, that's... Unless I get a potion right now, we lose. Okay, that could be a potion. Nope, we lose. Yeah, this problem can go problem because you can just do a lot of damage. This is still the fastest way to fight him, though. There's an alternative strat. You can also just use... Nope, psychic. I'm just going to reset. You can also just use Scyther. Scyther also bodies him, but the problem is Scyther is really slow in comparison to Mewtwo. Okay, him going first is not good. Oh, computer search is great to get right now because I can discard two cards and basically I can use his energy absorption attack. Basically, it's his first attack, can take two energy cards from the discard pile and put it on the Pokemon. So it allows me to use my second attack a lot faster. And the computer search allowed me to discard two cards in my hand, putting them in the discard pile, allowing me to use the attack. Now we've won. Good. This is how the fight's supposed to look like. There we go. That's Mitch. That's all the club leaders, so now we're gonna fight the Grandmasters, which are basically the same as the Elite Four. We're gonna fight four of them, then we're gonna fight the champion, who's Ronald, again, but we actually have to beat him that time. These fights are actually all pretty hard. No, Rod is easy, but the other three can be difficult. So first we're gonna take up Mewtwo, we're gonna switch to water, we're gonna use a, three seals, three dugong, that's a pretty good count. Wish I had more dugong, but it's fine. I'm gonna look through my trainers one more time. Add a fossil. Another removal is good. I'm gonna take out a full heal. We don't need them as much anymore. They're really good in the early game. I'm gonna put the rest of them as fighting. So the first fight is Courtney, she's a fire trainer. So a lot of the Pokemon are weird. By the way, Dugong is also one of the most powerful cards in the game. We only use it for two fights though. Actually, I think only one, but I don't know the new strat yet, so. I want to reset until I get Dugong. It's honestly worth it because Dugong just melts her. It has a 50 damage, 3 energy attack, kills everything. Though fun fact, the Moltres is not weak to water because none of the birds have weaknesses, none of the legendary birds. No, Courtney is not the easiest. Rod is the easiest, I'd say. Courtney can go wrong if she gets, okay, good, I got Dugong. Courtney can go wrong if she gets Arcanine, or she has a Moltres with a lot of energy on it. But other than that, this fight's pretty easy. One thing that really helps with this is that Dugong is not rare. It's uncommon, which makes it a lot easier to get it in a run. Please don't get an energy removal right now, that'd be terrible. I'm gonna Oak right now just to get some new cards. A potion, this thing I want, there we go. And, okay, there we go. I'm gonna probably start, I'll look at our Pokemon, see if I need to build anything else or not. Okay, no, we're fine. Oh, she has another Moltres. Okay, we're fine. She's not going to... Oh, she got rid of all my trainers. Okay. Lass gets rid of all the trainers in her hand. By the way, so she could kill... One interesting thing about the AI in this game. If they know you're going to kill them next turn, they will not attach to their active unless it will also kill yours by doing so. It's an interesting AI quirk. So, like, it has two energy. It needs three energy to attack. Oh, well, it's just not attached to it anymore. It helps a lot in the game. And it does help with AI manipulation that you know when you need to attack something or not. Yeah, I don't think I need to attack. I don't need to build a second seal. Oh god, I got confused. Fuck, that's not good. Just gonna use this bill in case it's a full heal. It's not. I'm gonna switch to the seal, attach an energy, treat to the dugong just to get rid of the confusion. By switching out, it removes status conditions. And there we go, that's Courtney. That's the last prize card. That's, okay, that's Courtney. So up next is, Steve. Steve's electric. So we're gonna be switching back to Diglett. Diglett Duck Trio. I think we're gonna be using this for the rest of the run. I'm gonna keep it for the final fight. So again, it basically kills all the Pokemon in his deck. The problem is he has Zapdos, which again, resists electric, just like Flying Pikachu. So, that's a thing. Okay, we have an Energy Search. We have two Fighting, Dugtrio, and, we have a Computer Search. I don't know, we have a great hand right now. This is probably the best possible hand you could possibly get. If I could have knocked out the Electabuzz that turn, that would have been great. Nah, I can't. I mean, I could computer search, but that's not worth it. It's worth saving the computer search. Yeah, whenever you place... No, whenever... There's like two... There's three different Zapdos, and he has two of a certain kind. Whenever you place that Zapdos down, it, does... It does 30 to a random Pokemon on either side of the field. That's the thing. Like, so I can do 10 damage, but once I can get to Earthquake, I can do 40 at a time, which is more useful. There we go. The rest of this fight is basically won now. I don't think there's any way I can lose. Unless Zapdos shenanigans. There are some Zapdos shenanigans that can make me lose. I just need to... Should look at his Pokemon, make sure he doesn't have... There's... Oh, god damn it, come on. Does he have the... Okay, he doesn't have that Zapdos. There's another Zapdos, not the one we just attacked, and not this one. This is the 30 damage to the bench one. There's another one that has an attack for 100 HP, which does kill Dugtrio in one hit. We don't want that, so if he ever plays that Zapdos, I need to kill it immediately. Don't let it get enough energy to attack. Eevee can also do 30 damage to me. Okay, good, it didn't. Let me make sure he doesn't have any other Eevees. He does, but he doesn't have a double color, so I don't have to worry about it right now. He could get another Zapdos and kill me, but if he does, then I'm going to RNG manipulate it away. I have two more bills, but I don't need to play them. This fight is one, I don't need to play them, that just takes time. It would be safe. Oh yeah, we just won. We won. The last prize card. Okay, there we go. Next fight is Jack. I'd say this is almost tied with Michael for being the hardest fight in the game. This fight is ridiculous. Not even, it's just that he has a ton of Pokemon that are just really dumb. Dugongs, which are really powerful. Articunos, which resist your Dugtrios. Chanseys, which waste your fucking time because of Scrunch. So, hopefully this doesn't go that badly. This is... Oh god, he has an Articuno on the bench. Do I play this now or next turn? Play it now. No, I should have waited. Oh, fuck, actually. I'm resetting. I didn't get Dugtrio. It's worth it because you need a Ductrio to take out the Articuno. So I just reset, just because I probably would have ended up losing. Otherwise, I would just have been waiting. I would have just been waiting to get a Ductrio, so just want to reset while I can. Oh god, not a Lapras start. I'm resetting. Lapras, that would have been a good start, but Lapras can kill you in two turns. So I would have lost next turn, probably. Hey, the Gust. Oh, hold up, but did I have a... Oh my god, are you serious? Like I said, the reason I need to reset is because this fight can be ridiculous. I need to have a good start. Okay, I have a computer search. Tons of good stuff. Energy removal, plus fire, good stuff. Okay, Chansey, that's actually a good start for me, because that means he can't damage me at first. Oh god, got a fucking oak, dear lord. Okay, this is good. He attached to the seal, which is what I want. Oh god, hold up, he got Dugong? Fuck, how much energy does he have on it? I don't want to reset yet, I'm going back to my turn so I can see what I need to do. Energy removal. This, I'm going to... I could computer search for a Gust, but I think it's more important to save it for the Ductrio. Oh, a Gust, that's actually what I want. Do I want a Gust right now? Yeah, I do. I want a Gust. Well, he's gonna get another seal eventually, but whatever. It's worth it, because Dugong does so much damage. I need a save. No, he's gonna try to confuse Raimi. I don't want that to happen. The energy removals are really, really powerful. Like, they're ridiculously insane, and just that you can prevent them basically from attacking. Ooh, Mr. Item Finder is good. I might want to save that to use an oak. Like, I want Item Finder, a search, and then search an oak. This might be a thing I want to do. Okay, he's set to the Ditto. The Ditto is useless. Like I said, this fight is ridiculous. Oh god, he got the Articuno. They paralyzed me. Are you serious? He's retreated to that too, cool. Yeah, I want an oak. I just want to completely refresh my hand. Another oak? Ooh, an energy mule. I can save that for later. He attached another to the Articuno. So as you see, he just attached another to the Articuno. Oh, wait, hold up. Does he do 40 or 30 damage with his attack? Okay, he didn't attach. See? I said he could have easily killed me, but he didn't. It would have done 40 damage to me, but he just didn't kill me because it's, like, random, so it's not guaranteed, even though it's the only Pokemon. Like, it's supposed to attack a random Pokemon he has in play, but it didn't because of that. I need potions right now. Because my Ductrio is looking pretty low. Does he attach you? Ditto? Okay, that's fine. Oh, another Item Finder. That is a good draw right now. That could be a potion. But I think we're just going to win this next turn. Yep. Oh, fuck. Okay, cool. I just need Item Finder or plus power. There we go. Yeah, they could die next turn, but they would have been able to kill me if they attached the energy. That's 40 damage. It would have done 40 damage to my Ductrio. But because it's It's programmed to attack a random one of your Pokemon. So technically wasn't guaranteed, even though it's the only Pokemon I had. Anyway, I'm glad Jack has done. That's a hard fight. This is a pretty easy fight. There can be a problem if he gets, like, Lapras, maybe. Actually, this could be a problem right now. Actually, no, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna keep it there. Let it do 10 more damage. I'm gonna kill it next turn. Also, the only... He also has Dragonair. Dragonair is also a threat, because it can... As an attack, it just auto-discards an energy, and that's scary. Oh, God, no. We got a fucking Lapras. Do I want a Gust of the Lapras? I do want a Gust of the Lapras. Actually, no, because he's going to attach another water and water gun me next turn. I don't want that to happen. Okay, good. He didn't kill me. That's actually good. Yeah, if he gets Hyper Beam on a Dragonair, then it just discards an energy whenever he uses the attack, which is not a thing. I hope that doesn't happen. Oh god, he's going for the water gun. Hold up, can I? I'm trying to see if I can do anything about that. I have another potion. I'd rather use it on this Diglett, whatever. Keep that Diglett alive. Okay, so I got a Ductrio. This fight actually is looking kind of scary right now, because I don't have any Ductrios, and he's doing a lot of damage. Okay, that's actually really good. Okay, he's not attaching any energy for some reason. This is looking good. I think we're gonna win now. Yeah, I don't know why he's not attaching energy, but oh well, I guess he won this. Yeah, we won. Okay. Yeah, Dratini doesn't have a weakness, which is kind of annoying. Are you fucking with me? Okay, well, never mind. I shouldn't have reset. He didn't attack me. Oh, wait. I'm still on that turn. Okay, I couldn't undo the Charmeleon, because it started my next turn before I reset. Oh, well. We won. And up is the final fight. Ronald 3. He can be really annoying, because he has a lot of energy removals. He also has all three of those legendary birds, which means they all resist Ductrio. We used to use a strat with Seal, but we think Dugong's faster anyway, or we think their trio's faster anyway, so we can do that. He also has Eevees that are weak to fighting, so that helps. By the way, fun fact, every trainer that the game thinks is, like, quote-unquote, like, a powerful trainer, like a gym leader or the lead four, the clubmasters or whatever, they will always have at least two basic Pokemon in their starting hand. Well, see, he's gonna have energy the rest of the game now, probably. Okay. Okay, I'm good. I have a computer search, so that's easy to get a that's a Ductrio. I think I've won this fight now. Unless he gets a Dragonair this turn. Okay, no, we're good. We've won. Now we're just gonna earthquake everything, and that should be the end. By the way, time is not immediately after balance. Time, I have to, like, talk to a machine, go through some text, and then it's time. There's, like, I have to look at, like, four different card animations. I don't know. It's weird. This one's actually went pretty well. I expected to go a lot worse, because I really had no practice with this before I started, because this is just a backup run. Oh, he has a player on the bench. Let's kill that. You die. Just because in case you can damage me or something. So I didn't have a lot of practice, but this one a lot better than I thought it would go. And my commentary went pretty well too, I think. It's a hard game to commentate because there's so many things going on. I have no full heals. Wow. Oh, this is actually a problem. Never mind, it's not a problem. Because I have energy removals. It's not a problem at all. If he attacked 3 energy, he could have potentially done 70 damage to me. But, you know, we don't care. We have energy removal. Oh god, he has a Dragonair. Do I have a Gust in my hand? I don't. I have a plus power, though. I can one-shot it. And he can, and I have 5 energy attached, and it's 4 for the Earthquake. So even if he does... Oh god, he could get 2 heads and knock me out with Slam. That's a potential... Oh god, that's not good. That's bad. That's bad. Okay, I want him to use Hyper Beam again. That's what I want him to do, because if he slams, he can kill me. Okay, good. We won. Now I get the full heal. By the way, what happened there was that he placed the Articuno, and when he plays the Articuno down, he flips a coin, and if heads, I get paralyzed. Whenever he play, puts it in play. So that's the last fight. There we go. Mashed really hard through all this text. It's gonna show me these 4 cards. And after the screen fades to white is on time. Not yet. Says this last card is gonna be a bit more text. And time. There we go. What was my time?
You got a 1 hour, 10 minutes, and 33 seconds, give or take 5.
That's not bad. Thanks for letting me run this.
Thank you for filling in on such short notice.
It's all good. Oh, fuck.
All right.
Yeah, thank you.
And we'll see you back tomorrow, I believe.
I'm doing Shadow the Hedgehog tomorrow. That's gonna be fun.
Definitely.
Yep. Thank you, buddy, for watching. And what's up next? Sonic Heroes?
Sonic Heroes.
You gotta
Team
watch
Sonic.
Sonic Heroes is a great run, and Sid is a great runner, so you're gonna wanna watch this. So, hope you guys have a good